Well, good morning. We greet everyone in divine love. We know right now the world is in a frenzy. People are worried and concerned about COVID-19. But we come as the Greater Pleasant Grove Baptist Church, Dubuque, Louisiana, to give you an encouraging word. If you have your Bibles, go with us to the book of Haggai, chapter number 2, verses 6 through 9. Listen to what the word of God says. For thus saith the Lord of hosts, yet once, it is a little while, I will shake the heavens and the earth and the sea and the dry land, and I will shake all nations, and the desire of all nations shall come, and I will fill this house with glory, saith the Lord of hosts. The silver is mine, the gold is mine, saith the Lord of hosts. The glory of this latter house shall be greater than of the former, saith the Lord of hosts. And in this place, I will give peace, saith the Lord of hosts. And the word of God is blessed. Let us pray, every head bowed, every eye closed. Father, we thank you, dear Lord, for this day. We thank you for your goodness, for your mercy, for your grace. Lord, we pray right now, Father God, for everyone across this nation, this world, who are suffering, oh God, with this virus. We speak healing right now, because we know, Lord God, only you can heal the land. Now, Lord, I ask you to use me as your instrument. Give me a fresh anointing to speak your word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Just for a little while, I would like to speak from the subject, an unshakable faith. Somebody say an unshakable faith.
Unshakable
an unshakable faith. Now, whether you know it or not, there is a shaking going on around the world. Events that were never once heard of are taking place in our day and time. Shocking stories in the news are getting national attention, from this coronavirus to even earthquakes and devastating tornadoes in Tennessee and even in Arkansas just a few days ago. People of God, we are living in the last days, and the signs of the times are unfolding right before our eyes. In other words, there is a shaking going on. And some people are too busy doing their own thing. They just don't even realize what time it is. The devil is busier now than ever because he knows that his time is short. That's why he's trying to do all that he can possibly do to throw this nation and this world off course and to cause people to live in fear. Don't drive at night. Don't travel on the boats or the airplanes. Don't drink the water. Don't send your kids to school. As a matter of fact, don't even come outside because the entire nation has been put on lockdown. Stay at home orders. People are being quarantined in the hospital as well as in their homes. Hundreds of thousands have tested positive for this coronavirus, and thousands have already died from the virus right here in the United States. Yes, the devil is trying to make us live in fear, and fear can paralyze you, causing you not to ever want to leave your house. Yes, people all over the world are living in fear. And if the devil can scare you, then he's got you. Because fear and faith cannot operate at the same time. So you're either living by fear or you're living by faith. That's why the Bible says the just shall live by faith. That's why it says that we are to walk by faith and not by sight. Because without faith, it's impossible to please God. That's why the devil wants to steal your faith and make you live in fear. But how many know that God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind? So you better get back, devil, because you can't scare me. You can't move me. You can't fake me. You can't shake me, because I have a faith that cannot be shaken. I have an unshakable faith. Somebody say an unshakable faith.
Unshakable faith.
Now, when we talk about an unshakable faith, I'm talking about being in a place in your relationship with God where the worries and the cares of this world don't bother you anymore. Yes, I said anymore because there was a time in my life when I worried about everything. I worried about how this or that would get done, how this would get paid, how that would get paid. I worried about the bills piling up. buying clothes for the children, keeping food on the table, keeping a roof over our heads. I worried so much that I began to work even 2 and 3 jobs at one time. I was working all the time and I was tired all the time, tired to play with my children, tired to go to church, too tired to exercise, too tired to do anything. And it seemed like the more I worked, the farther I got behind. But I read in the Bible when Jesus said, don't worry about your life. Don't worry about what you're going to eat or what you're going to drink or what you're going to wear, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all of those other things will be added unto you. I then decided to start praying about everything that I was worrying about. And every time the church was open, I was there seeking God's will, seeking God's face. And I found out that when you take care of God's business, that he will step in and take care of your business. And that's when I gave it over to the Lord for real. And guess what? He worked it out. Won't he work it out?
Amen.
Yes, he will. And maybe some witnesses here today that can testify how God worked things out in your life when you gave it over to him. An unshakable faith is when the cares of this world don't worry you anymore. It's a place of peace where you know beyond a shadow of a doubt that God is with you. And no matter what situations may rise up in your life, you know that God is able to bring you out with the victory. An unshakable faith knows that if God be for you, who can be against you? An unshakable faith knows that God shall supply all of your needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. An unshakable faith knows that no weapon formed against you shall prosper. I'm still talking about an unshakable faith. Somebody shout an unshakable faith.
Unshakable faith.
Looking quickly here in our text in the book of Haggai, we see the children of Israel who have just returned from exile, rebuilding the temple of God. Oh, they got off to a good start building an altar and laying the foundation, but all of a sudden the construction just stopped. And the people began to focus on their own lives, and they disregarded the house of God. So here we see the prophet Haggai being something like a praise leader, trying to pump the people up and to motivate them to finish the work of God. He tries to motivate the people to come back to church, to get involved in the work of the church, to get serious about God and his church. Yes, Haggai was an encourager, and he wanted people to get excited about serving the Lord. As a matter of fact, the very name Haggai, it means festive, which means to celebrate or to have a good time. This tells me that serving the Lord doesn't have to be dull and boring. You can have fun while serving the Lord. You can celebrate in the house of God. You can have a good time and still be saved. But in order to live life to the full, and to live the abundant life that Jesus died for you to have, you're going to have an unshakable faith. Somebody say an unshakable faith.
Unshakable faith.
Now, if we look closely at the text, we find in verse 6 that it's really God who's doing the shaking. In other words, the devil can't do anything without God's permission. Yes, everything that has happened in your life, God either ordained it or he allowed it. And whether you believe it or not, God is still in control of everything that takes place and happens in this world. Therefore, the purpose of the shaking is not always to bring me down, but rather to build me up. Yes, God has a right to shake his children every now and then, just to see if they're really trusting him or not. And when God begins to shake your world, you will never be the same. When God begins to shake your world, you will always come out better than you were before. So get ready for the shaking of the Lord. You better be prepared and embrace yourself, because ready or not, God is about to rock your world. That's why you need this unshakable faith that we're talking about today. Because when God gets through with you, you shall come forth as pure gold.
Amen.
Somebody shout an unshakable faith.
Unshakable faith.
So how can I have this unshakable faith, and what will it produce in my life? Well, I'm glad you asked, because in order to have an unshakable faith, you must have first have an unshakable foundation. Somebody say foundation.
Foundation.
A building can only be as strong as the foundation that is built on. And the Bible says in 1 Corinthians 3:11 that no other foundation can anyone lay than that which is already laid, which is Jesus Christ. Now, a foundation is designed to hold something up or to keep it sturdy, to keep it strong, to keep it stable. And if Jesus Christ is not the center of your life, then you're on the wrong foundation. If you haven't accepted Jesus as your personal Savior, then you're on the wrong foundation. If you have rejected the Lord and embraced some other false religion, then you're on the wrong foundation. Because I read in the Word of God that the stone that the builders rejected became the chief cornerstone. So if you don't have Jesus in your life, then you really don't have anything. I'm reminded of the songwriter who said, on Christ, the solid rock I stand.
Amen.
All of the ground is sinking sand. So if you don't have Christ in your life, then you're building on the wrong foundation. Somebody shout, an unshakable faith.
Unshakable faith.
So in order to have an unshakable faith, I must first have an unshakable foundation. And once I have an unshakable faith built on an unshakable foundation, then I can begin to enjoy some unshakable benefits. Oh, yes, yes, there are benefits from serving the Lord. As a matter of fact, Psalm 103:2 says, bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all of his benefits. And one of those benefits I can receive from the Lord is an unshakable family. Somebody say an unshakable family.
Unshakable family.
Yes, family is important to God. As a matter of fact, God instituted the family before he instituted the church. This is your family that God ordained for you to be born in, because your family is an extension of God's grace toward mankind. And God made families for a reason. And one of the main reasons he created family is for fellowship. Somebody say fellowship.
Fellowship.
Because it's not good for any man to be alone. That's why it's so important for families to get together every now and then. Keep in contact with your family. Stay connected to your family. And I found out that a family that prays together stays together. You see, God is pleased every time families come together on one accord. That's why the scripture says, behold how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. And whether you know it or not, God will bless families that are unified, because the devil has always been against the family. That's why he's so busy trying to tear families apart. That's why the divorce rate is up. Family, the number of gays and lesbians are on the rise, because the devil don't like family. The family is under attack, but it's time for the church to stand up and command the devil to take his hands off of our families, off of our church families, off of our brothers and sisters in the Lord. Take your hands off my children. Take your hands off my grandchildren.
Yes.
Take your hands off of my church family. Because God promised that I could have an unshakable family.
Amen.
Somebody say unshakable family.
Unshakable family.
Even if your natural family is kind of shaky, God has blessed you with a spiritual family.
Amen.
Which is your church family, who will love you and pray for you and stand by you when things get rough, or when a pandemic is going all over the world. It's good to be connected to a godly family. But in order to have an unshakable family, you must first have an unshakable faith. Somebody say unshakable faith.
Unshakable faith.
So the first benefit of an unshakable faith is an unshakable foundation, an unshakable family. And then the next benefit that we can have is unshakable finances. Somebody say finances.
Finances.
Does anybody want your money to be unshakable? Now, unshakable finances mean that I'm able to meet all of my financial obligations and still have money left over to share, to save, and to sow. Unshakable finances mean I can pay all of my bills, get to my church, take care of my family, keep gas in my car, maintain my personal appearance, while at the same time being a blessing to somebody else.
Amen.
Now, finances is another area where the devil attacks, especially true Christians, because true Christians have a giving heart that will help those who are truly in need. But the devil has even tricked some of us into thinking that money is evil. But the Bible never says that money is evil. It says that the love of money is the root of all evil. So money in itself has never harmed anybody. In other words, money can't hurt you. I say all the time that salvation is free, but ministry, it costs. Every time the doors of the church are open, it costs money, because lights and air conditioning is not free. Gas and water is not free. Telephone, electricity, and insurance is not free. Somebody say things cost.
Things cost.
Ecclesiastes 10 and 19 says a feast is made for laughter and wine makes merry, but money answers everything. Some of your prayers would be answered if you just had a little more money. Some of you wouldn't have to work 2 or 3 jobs like I did if you had more money. Some of you wouldn't be worried about how this is going to get paid, that going to get paid, if you had more money. See, verse 8 of our scripture says, it says, God says, the silver is mine, the gold is mine, says the Lord of hosts. Everything on the face of this earth belongs to God. And God has the power to take the money from the wicked and place it in the hands of the righteous. All we have to do is believe it and receive it, and it shall be ours. We should be like Jabez when he prayed, oh, that you would bless me indeed. Enlarge my territory. Keep your hands upon me. You see, God desires for his people to be blessed. God desires for his people to prosper. God wants his people to live an abundant life. Yes, he wants us to have unshakable finances. Somebody shout unshakable finances.
Unshakable finances.
But in order for me to have unshakable finances, I must first have an unshakable faith. So the first benefit of an unshakable faith is an unshakable family. The second benefit is an unshakable faith is unshakable finances. But then third and finally, I'm through. The most important benefit of an unshakable faith is an unshakable future. Somebody say unshakable future.
Unshakable future.
Yes, your future is secure if you're standing on the right foundation. Haggai 2:9 says that the glory of this latter house shall be greater than the former. In other words, what's coming is going to be better than what's been. See, your worst days are behind you, and your future is secured if you're in the Lord. In other words, the best is yet to come for the people of God, all because we are standing on this unshakable foundation, which is the Lord Jesus Christ. People of God, I don't know what you're going through right now. I don't know how you feel about what's going on in this world, but I do have a word for you today. Don't grow weary in well-doing, for in due season you shall reap if you faint not. For God says that he knows the plans that he has for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you a hope and a future. Yes, we can have an unshakable future because we serve an unshakable God who is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. All we have to do is trust him, take him at his word, and his words will never return void. Yes, heaven and earth shall pass away, but God's word shall abide forever. And God is not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he shall repent. If he said it, he shall surely bring it to pass.
Amen.
Does anybody here have an unshakable faith. Is anybody standing on an unshakable foundation?
Amen,
does
amen.
Anybody want an unshakable family, unshakable finances, unshakable future? Amen. Then put your hands in the master's hand.
Yeah.
Stand on the word of God.
Amen.
And watch God perform wonders in your life.
Yeah.
People of God, there's a shaking going on in this world. And the only way to survive is to have an unshakable faith. Come on, put your hands together. Give God some praise. We love you. We praise you. May God keep you, bless you. This is